Seem like to me, you dummies, you would have been asking him, who are you? How do you know this? And what can we do to get the knowledge that you have? That last question is a snare because we have become so lazy in crescendo. We don't want to look for nothing. We don't want to get on our knees and ask God to unlock mysteries of the Bible. We don't want to turn our plate over and fast. No. Because that is too inconvenient. So we have arose a generation of Christians, convenient Christians. God, you got an hour and a half on Sunday, and that's all you getting from me. And that's why it's a generation in the church and without that doesn't know God. But if we would dare to begin to know him and ask him, how do I get to know you? We can show the people in the church and without, our God still does miracles. Our God still works wonders. Our God is still amazing. But because there is a generation in leadership that does not know God. I said it's a generation in leadership that does not know God. Not bothering to ask of God, who are you? Father, reveal yourself to me. Let me see you for myself. I know my mama said you was good. And she said her mama said you was good. And she said her mama. But God is tired of he said, she said. He want to know what can you say.
Hey.
What can you say about me? I'm tired of he said, she said.
Hey.
I'm tired of you serving me on
come
she
on
said.
Now.
I want you to serve me on I know.
Come on.
I know it because I've been the way he took me.
Come on, prophetess.
I've been the way he took me. It was a rough side of the mountain, but it was worth it to know his glory.
My God.
Oh, I remember one time I had a vision. My God, I was 19 years old, and I was climbing up this mountain, and it was cutting my hands, and my knees was all scraped up, and sweat was blinding my eyes, but I could see something at the top of the mountain, and I was striving and using all kind of strength, every bit of strength I had, I was getting up that mountain, and God was taking me, what he was showing me, I'm taking you up the rough side of the mountain, you know, because when you go up the hard way, you begin to build character. You see, we got people in leadership right now don't have no kind of character because it was a flowery bed of bees thrown out for them. They didn't have to work to do nothing. That's all right. You can leave it. They didn't have to work to do nothing. They didn't have to struggle and scratch it. And they didn't have to stay up at night when everybody else was asleep. Y'all not saying nothing to me. It's been a many nights that I walked the floor when my family was asleep because it was something that I had to get from God. You see, I have a acquaintance named Virgil Green. And he told me, he said, Pastor Malaika, he said, but I'm not really getting no playing time. He plays for the Denver Broncos right now. I said, Virgil, let me tell you something. I said, he called me. I said, this is what you do. I said, every practice you play like it's a Super Bowl. Every practice you come early and you stay late. I said, because God is taking you someplace. And I said, you're going to get your opportunity, but you got to show faithfulness. I said, and God is taking you on the staircase and not the elevator. Because let me tell you about the staircase. On the staircase, you build stamina. On the staircase,
hey!
You building self-esteem.
Hey!
On the staircase, you understand that it's going to get tiring and you're going to need a power that's greater than yours. But you're going to have to exhaust all your power first and then you'll be able to call on God. But you watch this, son. I said, watch this. God, if you got to move somebody else out and cause him to be hurt, you're going to get your chance. But you better obey what I'm telling you. God is taking you by way of the staircase and not the elevator. See, in the elevator, all I have to do is reach my pinky out and push the button. That's it. I don't have to do nothing else. And that's what we got now, elevator Christian. We got them Christians and all they want to do is just push the button and everything is done. But that ain't the way of the kingdom, baby. Oh, no, it ain't the way of the kingdom. If you watch how Christ was crucified, that was an all-night-long ordeal. He didn't just go lay down on the cross and say, nail me, I'm ready to get it over with. No, baby, that was an all-night-old ordeal. And if you're going to have the glory of the Lord, you're going to have to put some skin in it. You ain't going to be, or you're going to be a part of that generation that don't know who God is. You're going to keep doing the same thing every year and keep getting the same results. Come on, you got to go back the way that God took you. Come on, somebody clap your hands right there. And the Bible says in verse 47 that they heard him and they were astonished.